Good news for motorists. Fuel prices are expected to go down for the third straight week. Estimates show gasoline could see the biggest cut of up to 2 pesos and 20 centavos per liter. A liter of diesel, meanwhile, could go down by at least 50 centavos. As for kerosene, prices are seen to decrease by as much as 70 centavos. The hot weather in the Philippines seemed to persist this month. Ada Perez talked to some experts on how to keep cool this summer in this report.
Stepping into this alley in Chamorro's, Manila would make you forget that you are still in urban Metro Manila because of the abundance of plants. Some are in pots, many are also hanging or in makeshift containers. Spouses Susana and Marcelo Rendon cite the benefits of having plants in this hot weather. They also grow vegetables.
Di ba tag-init? Medyo pag ang hangin kasi ano, may matatamaan na halaman. Medyo malamig naman at saka maaliwala sa pakiramdam. Siguro nakagawian na namin siguro na talagang wala naman tayong ibang libangan. Pati gulay, mayroong gulay sa ibubong, mga talbos, ganun.
Ano pong mga pagkain yung nakakatulong po para maibsan ang init? Yung mga meron yung na kayo dito?
Pakwan.
Pakwan. Yan, ilam na tubig, malamig.
According to an architect, it is difficult to avoid sunlight even in indoor areas as the Philippines is a tropical country and wide open spaces are limited in urban areas.
According to the Philippine Department of Health, it is difficult to avoid the sunlight even in indoor areas as the Philippines is a tropical country and spaces in urban areas are limited. But this is possible through using different sunshades.
Pwede natin introduce din yung curtains. Mas magandang pang sunshade talaga if ever maganda yung area ng bahay, magtanim tayo ng puno to block off yung sunlight. Tapos meron tayong nabibili ngayon yung plants na nakalagay sa walls. Isa pa yun na pwedeng igamitin para i-reflect natin yung heat ng sun. The lighter shade, mas hindi siya kumukuha ng heat. Kaya mas maganda lighter yung shade nyo.
Another tip, floor or stand fans offer better heat regulation than ceiling fans.
Yung heat kasi stays above and the cold air stays down. Kung ano yung ta-transfer mo papunta sa baba, eh yung heated na areas like the ceiling, medyo mainit, ang bubuga sa'yo medyo mainit. Pero kung kukunin mo sa flooring, mga floor fans or yung stand fan, tapos na nasa flooring, mas malamig ang ibubuga niya dahil ang kukunin niyang hangin, medyo malamig na.
According to the Philippine Department of Health, proper ventilation is equally important to reduce heat in indoor areas.
So ngayon naman ang kalaban natin is temperaturang mataas, no? So yung buksan yung mga bintana, yung mga pintuan, maglagay tayo ng mga electric fan. Kung kaya, maglagay ng aircon pero hindi naman required. Tapos siguro yung mga bubong, no? Kasi pag ang kisame mababa, typically mas mainit kumpara sa mga istruktura na mataas ang kisame, ang bubong, para mas maganda yung daloy ng hangin.
Mas ideal, malalaki yung bintana natin upang mag-circulate yung hangin sa loob ng bahay. Mas ideal na meron tayong at least dalawang bintana sa two sides ng walls.
If you're concerned about safety, grills or screens may be placed on windows to deter housebreakers. Ara Perez, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Education Department assures the public revisions to the senior high school curriculum will not delay its implementation, which includes additional technical vocational education and training for students. Joyce Balancho reports.
All the four strands of the senior high school program in public schools will soon incorporate the technical and vocational education and training, or TVET, in its subjects. This follows the signing of a joint memorandum circular by the Department of Education, Commission on Higher Education, Technical Education and Skills Development Authority, and the Department of Labor and Employment on Friday. This aims to equip learners with industry-relevant skills and knowledge necessary for their workforce readiness and employability. The current strands of senior high school are the general academic, humanities and social sciences, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, and lastly, accountancy, business, and management.
Across all tracks, i-embed yan. So whether you're in the academic track, not necessarily tech book eh, pwedeng sa academic track, at least meron sila, equipped na sila ng skills, they can take the certification, mas magiging attractive sila for employers.
DepEd is currently revising the senior high school curriculum, which is expected to be piloted in schools in academic year 2025 to 2026. It says these additional adjustments will not delay the implementation of the new curriculum.
So napakaganda ng timing na ito dahil since we are now reviewing the senior high school curriculum, isasabay na po.
DepEd is also coordinating with DOLED to assess the industry demands to match the skills needed by the K-12 graduates. Testa, for its part, commits to help DepEd in the curriculum change.
We have the bookkeeping NC3, then we also have yung customer services and customer care, kasama din po doon. Tinitingnan din po natin paano mailagay yung mga bread and pastry production natin, entrepreneurship. Ang dami ho, kasi ho, tinitingnan natin yung different sectors and then paano ho siya mailagay.
Senator Sherwin Gatchalian, the chairperson of Senate Committee on Basic Education, lauds the revisions in the senior high school curriculum. He said the number of Filipinos who were dissatisfied with the K-12 program continued to increase based on a series of surveys his team had commissioned in 2019, 2022, and 2023. He said respondents didn't see the value of adding 2 years in basic education.
So we commissioned again a survey in 2023, September of 2023, and the results satisfied 32% and dissatisfied 52%. Sabi ko patay na, no? More than half of our population is dissatisfied with K-12. No? They're not happy with K-12. In fact, they hate K-12.
He is also pushing for the passage of a law which will mandate government to accept senior high school graduates. He noted that the current standards in government are not suited for K-12 graduates. Under the proposed bill, the Civil Service Commission will be tasked to formulate guidelines for the acceptance of senior high school graduates in selected positions.
Taasan ng sweldo at bibigyan ng specific na pwesto ang mga senior high school sa gobyerno. Kung pumasa sila, of course, ng interview, ng mga assessment, pero meron ng specific na trabaho para sa ating mga senior high school. Limited position, but ito from local government, from barangay to local government, all the way to national government.
Meanwhile, senior high school students who have completed the Technical Vocational Livelihood Track or the TVL will no longer have to pay for the assessment and issuance of national certifications that they may need as requirements for employment. This follows the signing of a joint memorandum circular by the Department of Education and the Technical Education and Skills Development Authority on Friday that aims to institutionalize the mandatory assessment of grade 12 learners.
Libre na po yung assessment ng ating mga senior high school graduates sa TVET. No? Pag magkakaroon sila ng NC1 or NC2, libre na po yan. Ngayon, aside from yung libreng assessment ng ating mga learners na wala noon.
Teachers will also be trained to become assessors, while schools will also be accredited to become assessment centers. He stressed that securing a national certificate is a good boost for potential job seekers.
Pag bumasa sila, makakuha sila ng NC1, NC2, automatic yan. Magagamit na yan paghahanap ng trabaho.
To support the program, the national government has allotted 538 million pesos in the 2024 national budget. Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News.
The annual balikatan drills between the Philippine and U.S. militaries concluded Friday. Over 16,000 troops from the Philippines, U.S. and partner nations participated in this year's exercises. The troops also conducted their first ever multilateral maritime exercise, marking a historic milestone in regional cooperation. Philippine Defense Chief Gilberto Chodoro is looking forward to next year's drills. He teases the 2025 Balikatan exercises will involve a full-scale battle simulation.
Next year and the continuation of this year will be a busy one for all of us. And we look forward to this because exercises such as this, where at least on the Philippine side, we go out of our normal comfort zone and try to focus on actual soldiering, which is what how an armed forces needs to be.
President Marcos says joint maritime drills with Manila's allies help guarantee peace and stability in the West Philippine Sea. A local official warns the national government of a possible attack by China. In a report published by Japan's Kyoto News, Cagayan Governor Manuel Mamba says Chinese Vice Foreign Minister Sun Weidong warned him last year Beijing will not hesitate to attack Manila if a war erupted between China and other forces being hosted by the Philippines. The governor has been opposing the expansion of U.S. military sites in the country. He has also been pushing for his province, which is facing the island of Taiwan, to benefit from China's economic growth. China demanding the Philippines to cease its provocations and allow Chinese diplomats to perform their duties normally. This remark from Beijing's foreign ministry comes in response to Manila's national security adviser Eduardo Año, who called for Chinese embassy officials to be expelled. Año cited an alleged recording of a phone conversation with a senior Philippine military official about a purported deal with Beijing to de-escalate tensions in the West Philippine Sea. The two countries have engaged in a series of standoffs this past year as the Philippines steps up its assertiveness in its territorial waters.
The relevant statement of the Philippine side precisely proves that they have become weak in the face of facts and evidence, and that they have reached the point of exasperation and have no bottom line at all. China solemnly requests the Philippine side to effectively safeguard the normal performance of duties by Chinese diplomatic personnel, stop infringing and provoking, and refrain from denying the facts or acting rashly or lifting a stone to smash their own feet.
The Philippine government's Anti-Organized Crime Commission believes controversial Bamban Mayor Alice Guo has a major role in illegal pogo operations in the town. Authorities in March raided an internet gaming licensee in Tarlac, which showed evidence of human trafficking, serious illegal detention, physical abuse, and torture. 875 workers were rescued there. About half of them are Chinese nationals. Guo has been accused of backing the operation of the gambling site, with lawmakers questioning how such businesses in a local town thrived without being detected. The mayor has since denied her involvement, but officials assert documents can prove her link to the illegal activities.
Yung mga nakuha naming dokumento inside, yung especially po nung nag-apply po para sa business permit, nung hindi pa po mayor si Alice Guo, siya po yung naka-front doon. Ano? Siya po yung mismo nag-apply ng letter of objection para po sa konseho ng Banban Municipality. Hindi pa po siya mayor noon. And then nung mayor na po siya, at nung ma-raid itong Pogo Hub na ito sa Banban, may mga dokumento rin po na nagsasabi na siya pa rin po nang babayad nung sa Tarelco po, yung sa Tarlac Electric Cooperative, nasa pangalan niya rin po. Yung mga maintenance po ng building o ng compound, nasa pangalan pa rin po. Pati po yung ibang bill, yung mga telco bills, karamihan po nasa pangalan pa po niya. So yun po ang iimbestigahan talaga namin, kasama po namin yung DILG.
Aside from her ties to Pogos, Guo has also been under scrutiny due to her citizenship, with some lawmakers suspecting she could be a Chinese agent. During a Senate hearing, Guo revealed she does not have school records. Her birth was only registered when she was 17 years old. President Marcos urged ANU to cooperate with the International Criminal Court's probe into former President Rodrigo Duterte's bloody anti-narcotics campaign. The Philippine Coalition for the International Tribunal believes Marcos should participate in the probe, especially as extrajudicial killings allegedly continue under his watch. Marcos has asserted on several occasions the ICC has no authority to investigate his predecessor's drug war.
Dapat tayong makipag-cooperate. Kahit wala na tayo ngayon sa International Criminal Court, dapat makipag-cooperate tayo sa period na tinitingnan ng International Criminal Court. Yun sana yung magiging gabay ng ating gobyerno ni Presidente Marcos, ano, na rather than hindi kinikilala ang otoridad, patuloy pa rin po yung pagpatay. May according to the HAS, mga 600 po ang namamatay sa panahon ng Marcos administration. At recently, sinasabi na 15% ay doon sa Davao yung nangyayari. Lalo na nakakatakot po yung ano, yung I will kill you kung hindi pa kayo titigil, mga ganon ni ni Mayor Baste, no, sa Davao.
The Philippine Ombudsman orders graft charges to be filed against former Health Secretary Francisco Duque III and former Undersecretary of the Budget Department's Procurement Service, Christopher Lau. The Ombudsman ruled Duque and Lau are guilty of grave misconduct and ordered the forfeiture of all the retirement benefits and perpetual disqualification from public service. This stems from the alleged pandemic supply deals secured by Farmley Pharmaceutical Corporation during the Duterte administration. Duque's legal counsel told ANC they plan to pursue all available legal avenues to contest the ombudsman's decision. The law firm maintains all facts and evidence point to Duque's innocence.